Welcome back to Let's Read Dread, and today's episode is Citizen Snork Part 3. So we'll just dig into this. In a secret room in the city, soft light plays over a fine array of trophies. A collector's room, but no ordinary collection. Look closer. These exhibits are human. The greatest collection of human oddities ever assembled, for this is the home of a maniac. All right. And there's a bunch of these. So we've got the largest lips, the smartest man, which appears to be a guy with a big brain, two-thumb hand, several things that aren't labeled, moose man, longest beard. All right. And but hush, the door opens. The collector has returned with another prize.
A fine reward for my night's work. Come on, my beauty, let me gaze upon your immensity again. The biggest nose of all time, and it's mine! Mine forever! But wait, where's the jewel-studded nosepin? Stonk always wore it. Can it be? I've been thwarted. I must check the noose.
A mystery attacker tonight broke into the Just Plain Stupid Studios and stole the nose of show guest Herbivore Bung. We interviewed the only witness to the bizarre event, J.F. Snork, the man with the biggest nose of all time.
The burglar was after my nose. Got Bung's instead. What a dimbo. How could anyone mistake Bung's puny pilot for mine?
Oh, whoa!
I've stolen the wrong nose.
Next day, in Citizen Snork's apartment, Judge Dredd explained his tactics.
We've never managed to catch the collector because we've never known where he would strike next. This time we do. The collector doesn't settle for second best. He won't rest until he has your nose, and when he comes for it, I'll be waiting. You people just go about your business as normal. Forget that I'm here.
Righto, Judge, I'm off batting. Look out, world, here comes Easy Glider.
Aloysius Snork was a bat-gliding fanatic. It was Thursday when the collector struck. Citizen Snork was oiling his nose. Citizen Snork was oiling his nose. His mother, Malaria, was out sitting with a friend. His father was, as usual, batting.
Flap, flap. Back so soon, Dad? Good thing. Give me a hand with my oil tip.
Oh, give me a hand to oil my tip.
I came for your nose. I came for more than the tip, Beaky.
It's a collector. Shing.
Hold it, creep. Ka-ching. Mac of Lemon. It'll be more than his nose that goes.
You don't have a chance, collector. Let him go.
Okay, have him.
No!
The garbage grinder!
Ow.
Gotta free him. No shot.
Dang.
The collector's batting for it.
Ah! Flap, 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 flub. My nose! You shot off my nose!
It was your nose or your life, citizen.
A judge examined the collector's body.
His name is, Ashley Sakamoto. Got a place over at DeLorean.
Right, let's check it. In the DeLorean luxury apartment, the secret room yielded up its grim trophies.
Show was a kook, all right. Enough stuff here to clear up 50 unsolved crimes.
And let's see, we've got on the wall here, world's second biggest nose, and a spot for the world's biggest nose.
That's one space a collector will never fill.
What do we do with the rest of the collection?
Find which owners are still alive and return their parts. The rest can go direct to the next of kin. That'll be a nice surprise for them.
And what of Citizen Snork? The next day in Jimbo Cummings Block Hospital,
we can fit you with a whole range of artificial doses, James. Take your pick.
Gee, Doc, they're all okay doses, but it's just not the same.
And the noses are bulbous red, Roman classic, hooked small, Rob Smith Mark I, Retruce standard, or button cute.
With his new Rose Smith sewn in place, Citizen Snork returned to dull obscurity. His butterfly flight was over. And so's the story. The end!
Well, that was silly. Join us again next time for more Judge Dredd, where we ask the question, can it get sillier or will it get serious? Thanks for watching.